offer many ways to do a simple exercise. All right, I'll be right back and we'll get started soon. I'm back. I was just getting some updates on my son. He's in a volleyball tournament. So far, so good. All right. If you could see my setup, what me and Amber just did prior to us being hooked up was pretty hilarious. So I'm in a hotel room, if anyone just getting on right now. I am on a refrigerator right now, the hotel refrigerator, piled high with towels with my phone close to the screen as possible so you could hear the music. And then my floor mat, which is kind of right there, is a towel. And I positioned it perfectly so I know where you guys could see me on the floor. Life is just full of, things that get thrown at you. And it's how you do it and how you make best of a situation that gets you where you need to be. So no matter what happens in life, just got to keep moving forward, be strong and be positive, right? All right. We're going to get started in a couple of minutes, and I'm going to set my watch for high intensity interval training, and we will find out, if you're working with me directly and staying on my level, like around the calories you're going to be burning, heart rate, steps you'll be taking, it'll be fun. It'll be really good. We're going to start in 1 minute.
Good morning, everybody. Just a couple housekeeping things. This is set up as a webinar. So the way you can communicate with us this morning is to use the chat box. The chat box is located at the right-hand side of your screen. So if you go ahead and pull that up, you can say hello. If anything comes up where you're having some technical difficulties or you just want to make a comment, you can certainly do so. So go ahead and say hello to everybody. If you're ready to work out, that's fine. There's no need to communicate. You can just watch, get your workout, and sign off when we're done.
Hello, Patricia. Good morning. I'm seeing people logging in. Awesome.
Yes, good morning.
I saw a question. You don't need any equipment for today. Just your beautiful body, a bottle of water, and a mat. And then next week, we're going to use some weights. Okay?
And Susan, we cannot see you. This is set up as a webinar. So you're just going to see us today. And if you need to chat with us, you can put a comment in the chat box or you can raise your hand, which is at the bottom of your right-hand screen. And we could turn on your mic and you can ask us a question. So if you have a question at the end and you don't want to type it all in, just raise your hand and I will go ahead and allow you to do that. Throughout the workout, when I'm not going to have that option, but you can certainly type something in the chat box. And I'm here to help you with any technical difficulties you're having, so I could help you with that. So that'll be perfect. Good morning. We do have 3 more classes after this. So this is a 4-week series. So you can really jumpstart your new year and get on track for January. So we're excited about that. So we'll be here throughout the month of January, and it'll be the same thing, but next week you'll need weights. So we'll go over that with you, but welcome. Thank you for being here. And my name is Amber Gagliardi. I'm here at the library right now. So if you need me, just give me a call or type it in the chat box. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. I'll just explain again if anyone just joined in after what I spoke. My name is Despina. I'll be teaching the class today. Hi, Anne from Moon and Old Canada. Hello, Anne. How are you? I'm Despina. I'm in a hotel room right now because my son offered to help out his volleyball team, the older volleyball team. He's 14. He's playing for 16s today. So I'm in the hotel room and I just marked out my spacing and everything with Amber before we got started, and everything looked and sounded good, and I was visible. Today, all we need is just your beautiful body and a mat and some water. I'm going to offer many, many, modifications. If something is not right, I'll give you alternatives to do instead. Okay. We're going to have a great time. I just set my watch so we can figure out our calories and our burn. And I hope you guys are excited, and we're going to get started because it's 10:02 right now. All right. I'm going to get the music going and let's have fun, everyone. How are we sounding with the music? Are we good? All right, let's get started. March it out, ready? Right leg, go. Pull up. 3, 2, 1, step up. Hold on. 3, 2, 1, march it out. Four more, yep, daddy. 4, 3, back to the step, pop. Four more, 3, 2, pull that hamstring curl. 4 more, 4, 3, 2, knee lift. 4, 3, 2 more, 1. Pull it back to hamstring curl. 4, 3, 2 more. Down and up, hands on the hip. Now reach your arm up overhead. 4 more. 3, 2, reach that arm in front, abs tight. 4, 3, 2, arms down by your side. Step up, go. 4, 3, 2, march it out. Coming in, back up nice and tall. 4, 3, 2, knee lift. Hup, hup. Let your hand down, up, drop, and not equal. Now body nice and tall, arms go up and down. Any arm restrictions, your arms can change from here and here. Any shoulder injuries or issues with your neck, you can do that instead of your arms. We have 4 more. 4, 3, 2, double it out. Now you can try not to touch the ground. So with your core and stable leg. If this is hard for anyone, if you're close to a wall, if you're close to a bed, you're gonna hold on to that. So you have the security of something like this to help you with the balance. Yes? If you're okay, then stay in the center and keep going. You're gonna start feeling your quads start to fire up, yes? Abs nice and tight. 8 more. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, single, knee up. Up, 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 up. 4, 3, kick it down. Nice job so far. Just trying to get the blood pumping. Get the body warmed up. Hold the right leg front. Hands on thighs, flex your foot. Grab the toe toward back. Feel that stretch. If you can't go down, hands on thighs, stay right here. Head above your heart. Here, or you're here. Foot down, and then you roll it up.
other leg goes front, hands on thighs. Grab that toe for a back stretch. Or you're staying here with hands on thighs. Push down the knee, roll it up slow. Deep breath up, exhale out. Bring your hands in your shoulders so they stretch inside your neck, coming in tight. Up and over the other way. Bring your head up, chin to chest. Head forward, deep breath one more time. Exhale out. Ready? Toes front, squat. From the side. Make sure your knees do not go over your toes. Head stays above your heart. If anyone has a back issue, hands on your thighs, just the foot you go down. Everybody's belly must be stuck in your thighs. Woo! We have four, three, two. I'm going to change it. It's a three and one. Three, two, one. Squeeze your butt. Three, two, one. Squeeze your butt. So when you come up, squeeze your butt. Woo! Squeeze. How are we feeling, everybody? Is everyone's tummy stuck in? Say yes. I heard you. Come on. Woo! Two more. I'm going to change it. It's going to be somewhat similar. One more. We're going to figure this out. Let's go. Down, squeeze your butt. Down, squeeze your butt. Down, squeeze. Eight more. Eight. Seven. Six. Get ready. Five. Four. We're going to add something to this. Three. Woo! Two. One squat, one knee. 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 Now remember, balance is an issue. Hold on to something. If you can't go down all the way, look what I'm going to do. Modify the movement. Make it smaller so you feel better, yes? Keep it going. Eight more. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two more. One. Hold it down. Now we're really hold. Ooh. Our quads are burning now a little bit, yes? Watch those knees. Don't do this. Never. Back your knees. Here. Hands on thighs. Coming in. Woo! We have eight more. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four more. Three. Two. One. Roll it up. Woo! March it out. Woo! How are you feeling? By the second exercise, you're more warmed up. The blood's pumping. The heart rate's going a little bit, yeah? Keep it marching. Four. Three. To give our legs a little bit of a break, we're going to go to arms. Four. Three. Step. Hip. Hip. Deep breath up. Exhale out. Into the nose, inhale. Out through the mouth, exhale. Stop halfway down. Make it tight there. Shoulders, relax them down. My hand, slightly below my shoulder. Not above it, slightly below. Small, tight, circle, stop. Woo! It's small, so just so you know, my elbow is not locked, it's slightly bent. But I have a strong arm. No wailing, no flapping arms. Strong arm. Now, shoulder and neck is an issue. Watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to lower down. But I'm still going to be strong. So if someone comes around and tries to push your arm down, you're going to fight. That's how strong you are, yeah? Good. Come on. Breathe. Those muscles should be nice and tight. We have four more. Four. Three. Now flex your hand up and down and press. Notice my elbows are bent, but my arm is moving as one unit. and it's strong and tight. Are your abs in? Say yes. Yes, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, tight fist, loose circles going backwards. Small. Come on, 8. You're starting to feel those shoulders a little bit. Yes, let's do this. Remember, no flapping, easy arms. They've got to be strong and tight. You can lower the arm a little bit if you want to feel less tension in the neck area, yes? Come on, ready, more. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Flex your hands up and down. Woo! How are we feeling? All right, here's a little variation you're gonna love. On 8. Palms up, palms down. Palms up, down. Up, down, up. This little rotation of the wrist is gonna make you feel your arms more, yes? Down and up. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Come on. 8, 7. Coming in, 6, 5. Elbows slightly bent. 4. Arms are strong. That's a nice and tall. Keep it moving. You have 8 more. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Press it down. Woo! How are we feeling? And this is with no weight whatsoever. You're just using your own resistance, your own body. We're almost there, guys. Come on, keep breathing. You got 4, 3, 2, shake it out. Woo! How did that feel? Is that fun? Yes, it was. 4, 3, 2, deep breath. Exhale out. How are we feeling? Okay. If you're by a wall, if you're by a sturdy cabinet, a counter, or a bed, I want you to stand by it, okay? We're gonna work on balance. If you can balance without anything, awesome. But if you have a little bit of problem with balance, or injury in the knee, in the hip, or the ankle, I really like you to hold on to something more stable, just for a little bit of security and stability. So just put your hand, it can make a difference what leg you start with. Standing right is bent, body is tall, leg lift, lift. So even though my legs look straight, I do not have a locked knee. My knee is slightly bent, but my legs are strong and straight, and I'm looking to do 1 minute. There we go. Lift. So when I lift my leg up, I'm making sure my kneecap is facing towards that direction, forward. Yes? I don't want my toe and knee facing up. That's not what I want. I want toe and knee facing forward. Lift. So my standing leg is slightly bent. And occasionally, I will let go to make sure I have to balance. Yeah? Or are you holding on lightly with a couple of fingers? Just for stability. Are you ready? Hold your pulse. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Shake it out. I'm not done yet. It's a little shaking out. Just so loosen up the side of the butt, side of the thigh. You have 4 more. Get ready. 4, 3, 2. All right. Hold it up. Same exercise. Now leg is bent. Here you go. Lift. Lift. Who already feels it? The side of your back already tight? Awesome. Also looking at the side of the thigh, yes? Woo! Lift. Yeah, there's more. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, last one, hold it up, hold it, hold it, hold, 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 woo! Look at that, awesome. Big nice stretch. Hold it up. Hands on thighs. And stick your butt to the right side. So I'm leaning on my back right heel. Hands on thighs to back support. Sitting at a kick. Deep breath. Stretch right there. This legs look awesome. Bring it up. And stick your butt to the other corner of the room. So then we're leading from to my left heel, next left heel, yes? Hands on thighs, the back to forward, coming here. Come up, shake it. A little intermission, going back to arms. Ready? Step kick. And then look at the other leg. Deep breath. Exhale. One more. Hold your hands up. Exhale over here. And two. Bring those elbows together. Three. Three. So every time you squeeze your elbows together, you should feel these muscles, your chest muscles, lift up and squeeze tight. You feel some kind of pulsating here. Squeeze. Come again tight. Backs of the feet tall. Two fingers. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it together. No space. Straight up. Up, 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 up. Keep it moving. Try to minimize the space between the elbow and the forearm. Try to keep it as close as you can together. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, bump it in. In. Keep on squeezing, guys. Squeeze. Are you feeling this? Doesn't this feel awesome? 8 more, let's go. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, bring it up. Again, close that space. Don't go over your head. Straight up. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, one more step. Come on. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, shake it out. Woo! How was that? Was that awesome? Woo! Deep breath up. Exhale. One more time. Woo. Exhale. Okay, guys, now we get to another stable area. I'll use the bed this time. And I'm going to turn over the other area because I'm going to adjust it. Being in a hotel room is challenging, but we can do this. Ready? Come in, knees slightly bent, body tall, leg lift. Neck. Neck. So, occasionally, my hand comes off. I want to practice balancing. Sometimes I lose my balance, and that's normal, that's okay. Hold on, you have to, yes? Yes, so remember, new pose and new releases, take whatever's not in the face. If you're up in this way, that's where you face it, but I'm going to finish it with a discussion. So my new pose is in front of us. Standing legs side again.
Christina, is there any way you could just talk a little louder?
Talk a little louder, you guys.
Yeah.
8 more. 7. Is that better? 6, 5, 4, 3, 2 more, 1. Hold it up, pulse it. Up. Keep pulsing. I'm going to slow it down a little bit. Sorry, I just got her that you can't hear me, so I'm going to try to talk a little louder, okay?
And we could just lower the music a little, too.
Yeah, okay.
That was the feedback I got from
people. Keep on pulsing. Work that leg. Keep going. Is that a little bit better? Yeah. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, shake it out. How was that, guys? Sorry, I think we've been a little longer than the last time.
But oh, it's great.
A little bit better. Is that a little bit better?
We're good. All we're right, doing our leg lifts here at the library, too.
Oh, thanks, Amber. I appreciate the feedback. It helps a lot. Okay, get ready, guys. Hold on again. Doing the same thing with the bent leg. Let's go. Lift. Lift. So if I face or face front of this, it's perfect. When I face front, my laces are facing front. Yes? I'm kicking it a little bit. I'm turning on the angle. Again. Take your hands off every so often to see if you got your balance. Yeah? Up. 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 4. three, two, last one. Hold it up and pulse it. Up. Yeah. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, two, shake it out. Did you feel that? Right here. Side of thigh, side of butt. Even. Side, lower back. Side, lower back. That's where your muscles are. Woo! March it out, shake it out. Keep going. Four more. Three. Two more. Take a deep breath out. Exhale. Again, exhale. Arms again, are you not excited? Kick it out, yes. So when you're doing this, I want you to resist. Elbows are bent, hands below your shoulders, shoulders down. When you come in, you're gonna feel these muscles, your chest muscles, again, they have to pulsate. You gotta resist, resist. Woo! Palms facing like you're fluffing up a pillow. Come on, resist. Squeeze. Notice my hands are below my shoulders. I don't want them above because that causes my shoulders to lift up. I want shoulders down. Here. Anyone with a bad shoulder or neck, your hands are lower here. Okay? Keep on squeezing. Come on. Four. Three. Now palms push away. So I'm facing my palms on the outside, and like you're pushing through a crowd. Do not lock your arms straight. Are your abs sucked in? Say yes. Yes. Eight more. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Palms in. In. Squeeze. Resist. Squeeze. 4, 3. Now crisscross arms up and down. Here. Squeeze nice and tight. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Now we're going to lower the arms and raise the arms. Watch. 1, 2, 3, 4. Up. 2, 3, 4. Down. 2, 3, 4. Up. 2, 3, 4. Down. 2, 3. Are you squeezing as tight as you can? Or are you letting your arms flail? Loosey goosey. Say no to that. No to that. Back up. Back up. Down. Back up. One more time, down. Bring it back up. Now stay center. It's 4, 3. Back to fluffing up that pillow. Here, squeeze, squeeze. We got 4, 3. Tummy's in. Palms push away. Push. Woo! Come on, guys. We got 4. I'm gonna move back down. There's a cabin in the way. Keep it going. 4, 3. Flex it down to the side. Oh, do you feel it right there? Isn't that awesome? Woo, like holding the doorknob in your hand. Rotate the shoulder forward. Rotate the shoulder forward. Squeeze, squeeze. Remember, tight on. Come on. Bring those shoulders forward. Forward, forward. 4, 3. Shake it out. Woo! How are we doing? Now you should be able to see my feet again. Yes? We're doing awesome time, guys. Awesome time. Get ready. 4, 3, 2, 1. Open wide. You have to widen than your hips. Turn your feet out a little bit. Yes? Now we're going to do a turned out squat. I don't want your foot turned out this way. Just the slightest turn out is all I can have to say. I don't mean extreme ballet position turn out. So we're going to go down. So when I do my squat, I want to make sure my knee does not go, I'll show you, over my toes. Bad. I feel it in my knees. So you want a wide stance. You can hold on to something for stability, yes? So right now, I have my knees lined up with my heel. When I come up, you don't want to hyperextend and lock those knees up. Terrible. Straight leg, slight bend in the knee, tummy in, back up. Down. Down. So if anything, I feel a nice stretch in the groin, hip flexor area. Also feeling it in the thigh area, yes? Awesome. So you can hold on if you need that stability. Now pulse it down. Press. Woo! All your weight is on your heels, not your toes. How are we feeling, everybody? We're staying in the zone where you're gonna feel your thighs talk to you. Like, what are you doing to me? This is enough. We're gonna breathe through it and exhale out. Gotta breathe through it. So just so you know, you get breathy when you work legs. These large muscles require a lot of oxygen to burn fat. Yes? Press. Press. Woo! Are we feeling this already? I can't hear you. We have 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Ready? 3, 1. 1, 2, 3. Up. Don't lock your knees. And try not to move your back forward when you go down. The back stays up. Yes? 3, 2, 1. Up. 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 3, 2, 1. Two more. 3, 2, 1. One more. 3, 2. Down and up singles. Down. Try to go down as long as you can without bringing your back forward. Really challenge yourself. If you can't, staying right here is just as good, yes? 8, 7, 6. We have a challenge coming up. 5, you're not excited? 4, get ready. 3, 2, 1. Hold it down. Pulse. Oh, do you feel that? Keep it going. Woo! Woo! My heart rate's going up. Come on. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Shake it out. Woo. How are we feeling, everybody? Are we okay? Now step, kick it out. Move those arms. We have 4 more. 4, 3, 2, 1. Deep breath up. Exhale. Into the nose. Inhale. Exhale through the mouth. One more time. All right, guys, get ready. So go back to your stable area. Whether it's a bed or a counter, you're facing that area. Notice my knees. This is a lock knee, never. Watch my knee now. Slightly bent. Notice the butt. Slightly tucked under. Abs tight. Hold on. Calf raises. Lift. Down. Lift. So when you go up and do a calf raise, I want you to stay on your big toe. Almost feels like your knees are coming in a little bit, right? When I'm staying on my big toe. Do not do this. And roll out on your pinky toe. Not good for your foot. Stay on the big toe. And the bone right underneath the big toe, which is considered the ball of the foot, you're going to stay on that. So there should be minimal to no weight on the pinky toe and the toe next to it. Okay? And now lift and down. Up. New beat. Hold on. Ready? Up, down. Up, down. Up. How are we feeling, everybody? Are we okay? Good. Now you want to feel it some more? Pick it up. 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 So this exercise is awesome. If you lose balance a lot, if you have weak ankles, if your ankles keep out on you or roll out on you, and you always sprain your ankles, this is the exercise you want to be doing. Almost every day you can do this exercise. I was a gymnast, and I had a 3rd-degree sprain on my left ankle, and they told me I was better off breaking it because I reached them and just like somebody tumbled the ligament. Now we're going to pick this up double time. Up, up. And this was my therapy. Half reason. I laughed at my therapist, but he really helped me a lot. And I did one legged calf raises, reverse calf raises, and lift the toes up, and it brought my ankle back stronger than ever. Keep pulsing. 8, seven, six, five, four, three, shake it out. Woo. How we feeling? Kick it out, right leg. All right, guys. We're gonna stretch those legs out, and we're gonna go down to the ground. Now hold the right leg forward, hand outside. Reach your legs out, pull it back, or stay here with the foot flat. Abs in tight. We have four, three, two, foot down, bend and roll it up. Left leg front. Hands on thighs to back support, coming in. If you want, you can do stand up, pull the paw off. If you don't feel comfortable, you stay right here, foot flex. Four, three, two, foot down, bend the knee, roll it up. Deep breath. Exhale out. Let's go put our hands on our thighs, flat back, round the spine. Up, two, down, two. Up, two, down, one more. Up, two, down, roll all the way up. And shake it out. Get a quick drink, get your mat, and we're gonna go down on the ground. You guys are doing amazing today. Now, why do we have no equipment? The real reason, I'll tell you the real reason. Because my husband took the car to drive my son to the volleyball game, and my mat and my dumbbells are in the car. This is me fixing it up, and we can work it out. I got a towel, hotel towel, and my body, and this is all we need, right? All right, so we're laying down on our backs. I'm going to lower the music just in case you can't hear me, because now I'm going to be on the ground. Okay. How are we doing with that? Are we okay? All right, actually, we'll leave the music on. Okay. Laying down. I got a perfect angle where I don't hit not everything. Okay, hands behind the head. Let's start with some abs. Ready? We crunch. We lift up and down. Up, down. So notice, my chin is slightly in my chest. And I lift. And I lift. Now I work sometimes doing abs without my hands behind my head. But if you have a bad neck or a bad upper back area and shoulder, I really want the hands behind the head to give you the support that you need. I like to work my neck muscles so they want my neck muscles don't have saggy neck when I'm getting older. But if that is not, just cramps up that. So that's negative about working out with no hands behind your head. So if that happens, put your hands behind your head every so often, yes? Let's keep going. Up, up, up. Ready? Up, pick it up. Up, up, up. Squeeze your abs nice and tight. Press your belly button to the ground. And squeeze. When you squeeze, you exhale at the same time. It's so important to get that breath right. So whenever you're exerting the most force, you have to let that breath out. Press, press. Hold it up. Arms by your side and pulse. If this bothers your neck, hands behind your head. Woo! I want you to concentrate on your belly button, pushing into the ground. Press. We have four more. Four, three, two, hold it. Reach for your heels. Reach, reach. Now look, I could do this with my hands behind my head, or do one hand behind my head as one hand reaches the heel. Yes, you are working your obliques. Your obliques are your parentheses to your six pack, yes? Woo! 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Let's do another set. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Relax and breathe. How are we feeling? Are we okay? Awesome. We're gonna go back to abs in a second. Ready? We're gonna work some butt, my favorite thing to do. Make sure your heels are not close to your butt like mine are. No. Because when I go up, I feel it in my knees. Get your heels away, keep them flat. Actually, toes up, and now butt top. Tilt the pelvis up, squeeze it tight. Squeeze. So how do I say this? You have the winning lotto ticket in your butt crack, and you want to squeeze and clench your butt cheeks as tight as possible to keep that winning lotto ticket there and not let it fall out. And never let your butt relax. You got to squeeze really tight. The harder you squeeze, the more you're going to feel it. When you lift your toes up off the ground like I asked, we're activating the hamstring, the back of the thigh, as well as your butt. So it's a two-in-one exercise. Are you not excited for this? Squeeze. Tilt that pelvis up. Squeeze that butt cheeks together. Squeeze. Ready? Pick this up. Up. Squeeze. Now don't let your butt touch the ground anymore. Notice my butt is not touching the ground, but it comes close. It comes close. All the weight is on the upper part of your shoulders and your heels, yes? Keep squeezing. Squeeze it. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, hold it up. Squeeze it tight. Triple time. Up. Keep on squeezing. The movement is small, but the feeling of it is tremendous. The harder you squeeze, the more you're gonna feel it. Keep it up, tighter, squeeze it, tighter. Keep it going. Squeeze. Woo! 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. We'll set another set. Okay. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Another set. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Shake it out. Pull your knees in your chest. Stretch it out. How are you feeling? Woo! Ankle circles. Stretch that out. All right, guys. Legs down. Now what we're gonna do is back to abs. Hands behind your head. We're gonna lift our knees up, reverse curl, and tap. Lift. Little reverse curl when the upper body crunches at the same time. So I'm bringing my upper body up and my legs up at the same time, trying to get a reverse curl. Lift the hips slightly off the ground and you feel it in your lower abdominals as well. Don't slam your feet down on the ground. Lightly tap them every time. You'll feel your lower abdominals even more. Lift. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Shake it out. How we feeling? So I keep hitting the table, that's why I'm laughing. I'm hitting everything. It's okay. Hands behind your head. Side to side we go. Side. Center for two. Side, we go, here we go. Side, down, center, two. Side. Center, two. Side. Center. Side. Center. Side, center, side, center. One more time. Center. Shake it out. Nice job, everybody. Woo! So what we're gonna do next, we're gonna roll it over on all fours. I can definitely do this. I have my bun hitting onto the bed, my foot hitting onto the desk. This is so much fun. Okay. We're gonna do a plank hold. We got a couple of minutes left. We're killing it today. We're doing amazing. I'm gonna show you two different ways to do it. Well, actually, three. This would be one. Okay. This would be two. This would be three. Yes? I don't want to see your booty sticking up in the air like this. The booty have to be in line with your hips or you're going to be here. Ready? Everybody up in your plank hold. Now, go. Up. Squeeze nice and tight. Do not let your lower back arch like this. I don't want to sway. I want it up. Motivation, given my reputation. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, and down. Sit back on your heels. Reach your hands in front. We're in a child's pose. Reach those hands way down in front. Chin and chest. Sit back on your heel. Up on all fours. Round the spine. Up. Two. Down. Two. Up. Two. Down. Two. Up. Two. Down. Last one. Hold it. Curl your toes under. Lift your knees up off the ground. Downward dog. You can do a modified downward dog in this position. If that does not feel good to you, you can go back to child pose and hold it. Back down on your knees. Back to child pose. Back on all fours. Curl those toes under. Lift those knees up again. Downward dog. Knees are not locked, but they're straight. Knees slightly bent. Walk your hands and feet together slowly. If anyone has a bad back, I would like you in this position. Elbows resting above the knee. That way you have no pressure in your back. And you can straighten your legs as much as you want to, keeping your back in a safe position. Or if you're comfortable here, you stay here. Roll it up slow. Take your time coming up, please. Head is always the last thing that comes up. Facing front. Deep breath up. Exhale out. Left arm up and over to the side. Stretch. My hand is resting to support my back. My knees are bent, but strong. Round the spine forward, hands on thighs. Roll it up to the center. Other arm up and over, hands on thighs, the support of the back. Abs tight, knees slightly bent, hold. Round the spine forward, chin and chest. Hands on thighs. Roll it up to the center. One more time, deep breath up. Exhale out. Relax your ear to your shoulder. I love this stretch. I feel it in the opposite side of your neck. Up and over. Head up. Chin to chest. Hands gently behind your head and bring it in. I also tuck my pelvis under a little bit. Abs tight. This is an awesome stretch I feel in the upper part of my back and the lower end of my neck. Release the hand, head up, shoulder roll slow, up, two, switch. Again, up, two, three, one more. Deep breath up. Exhale out. Last time, guys, deep breath up. And exhale out. Awesome job today. I am sweating in a hotel room. I hope you guys all had a good time. If you have any questions, let me know. And next week, we're going to need a pair of dumbbells and a mat. And I'll have a little bit more room. I can do more leg lifts and stuff. So I'll do Pilates circles and when we get on the ground. I was very restricted with my leg movement, but it worked out fine for the first time, I think. I hope you guys enjoyed yourself. And I will see you next Saturday at 10. Oh, yes. Very good. Thank you. Thanks, Jennifer.
Yeah, that was great. We are, I mean, wow. I can't believe you could do all that in that little space. That was awesome.
I know. And I felt like I was limited, but I feel I got a good work. I am sweating.
So yeah, everyone, make sure you come back next week. We'll keep on track. It'll be the same time, 10 o'clock. So make sure you remember to join us again next week. I'll send the link out about 9 o'clock again, so everybody gets it in their inbox. So I'll make sure to do that.
I don't know if you can see my watch, but we did a total of 4,380 steps. That was 2.48 miles if we were walking. I burned 352 calories in that class. I don't know if you can see my watch. Can you see my watch? Is it blurry? Is it blurry? I don't know. I'm trying for you to see it.
Okay. So I do have a question, Leah. We did record it. So that will be posted on our YouTube page. So if you want to practice anything throughout the week, you can certainly do that and then build upon it next week. So that is an option for you. Absolutely. Just go to mcpl.tv and you can watch it. Looks like there is a question. I don't know if there's
modification on a mat. I saw just part of it. Yes, I was very limited with space. So I didn't do many modifications on the ground, but I promise I will next time. I tried to make a lot of modifications with the hands being placed behind the head to support the neck and the back, which a lot of people seem to have a lot of injuries in the neck and the top part of your shoulder. I could definitely will do different modifications for you next week. I just kept it simple. Oh, you're welcome. Thank you so much, Patricia. I appreciate it. I kept it simple with crunches and just like twisting exercises. If the leg lifts bothered you, it was very helpful to show the right and wrong. Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. I really try to make a conscious effort to show you proper form and technique. I will definitely keep offering modifications for everything. I can guarantee you that because I was a gymnast. I don't know if you heard me. I have back issues. I had two knee surgeries. I had a third degree sprain in my ankle. I mean, I destroyed my body. And now I'm paying for it, but I could still work out in a safe manner and feel great about it and still feel strong. So yes, I will do that. Thank you so much. I appreciate that, Anne. Go ahead, Amber. I'm sorry I interrupted.
Oh, no, you're fine. You're fine. Somebody had their hand raised, Alicia, but then it looks like she left. So perhaps she just clicked the wrong button. Looks like she's gone. Thank you, Teresa. Yeah, I mean, I cannot believe how much you did in that little space. That was awesome. Next week, I'm going to do the exercise. So I'm excited about that. This week, we had a...